Hello again, I'm Rodney Reynolds and welcome to another video review. Today I'm looking at the Aragon 900 water cooling system. What's included is the user's manual, all the materials needed for installation, a small funnel, thermal compound, an expansion slot bracket, a CPU water block, pump, an extension fan cable, two supports for the radiator including two fans which are pre-installed, tubing, a tank or reservoir, and the coolant. The CPU water block is very well designed and has a smooth, solid copper base which will make excellent contact between it and the CPU. There are also two holes for barbs which are covered with protective tape. The 240mm radiator is all copper with high density two row fins to maximize heat dissipation and comes with two 120mm blue LED fans pre-installed that get connected into the motherboard's fan header. There are also two holes for barbs which are covered with protective tape. The two included aluminum supports can be easily mounted onto the radiator. And this is wonderful if you're installing the radiator outside of the case or just testing it outside of the case. If the radiator is installed outside the case, they include an expansion slot bracket with three holes. Two are for tubes to pass through, and the other one is for the extension fan cable to pass through. The pump is compact and quiet with a flow rate of 360 liters per hour. Note the direction of flow on the pump. This is in and this is out. This is extremely important when you're plumbing the system. This pump comes with a 4-pin Mullex power lead that gets connected into the power supply and an RPM monitor lead which gets connected into the motherboard's fan header. This pump can be mounted onto the case using the pre-installed sticky tape. Just peel it off and stick it inside the case in a preferred location. Also note the rubber on the bottom of this pump, and this is to prevent vibrations. The reservoir has rubber on the bottom, a drain hole, and two holes for barbs. As well, at the top there's an attractively designed fill cap which can be very easily unscrewed. And note that there's another hole in the center of this cap that can be used to fill the system if preferred. Installing barbs and connecting tubes on the CPU water block, radiator, and reservoir is the same procedure. The barbs are integrated in the pump, so that's not an issue. I'll use the CPU water block to demonstrate how easy this is. First, peel off the protective tape. The direction of flow is indicated on the CPU water block, in and out. Now, screw both barbs all the way in. And once you've done this, you can tighten with a wrench just to make sure that they are attached securely. Now, just slide a clip over the tube and slip the tube onto the barb, and then push it all the way down and secure it with the clip. Remember that before cutting the tubes, measure the lengths based on the component placement in the case, and I would recommend testing the water cooling system outside of the case for 12 to 24 hours to be certain that there are no leaks. Finally, have a listen. This is one of the very best water cooling systems on the market. They've packaged it extremely well, included quality components, and the performance is excellent. Now remember, you can always add another water block or two to the loop, and also if you want to, you can add another radiator, depending upon what you're doing. Overall though, this is a 100% kick-ass product. Until next time, take care.